Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is July 3rd, 2021. This is my 8th episode about modern C++ experiments. We will learn how to overload class-specific operator new and delete. We will also learn memory leak detection on command line. Please understand that C++ library extension in this website I updated C++ library extension today. That means you have to download C++ extension library. And by watching super powerful C++ library extension this video, by watching super powerful C++ library extension, you have to set up cppextension.zip. Otherwise, you may not be able to follow my current and future sessions. In the C++ 17, the complete guide in this book, chapter 30 of this book discusses operator new and delete. So, if you want to follow my current and future session, I would highly recommend you to read this book. Without further ado, let's get started. Start Visual Studio Code. Open your working folder. Create a folder 008 overload new. We will create two files, leak detection.cpp. We will create another one, overload.cpp. Now close this file, Ctrl V. I will copy and paste these links. Include talk.fun output.hpp. Include talk.fun memory leak detect.hpp. Talk.fun sstream stream constant auto and talk.fun and void test memory leak detection auto ptr new int dynamically allocate size of int bytes delete ptr stream our message and int main we call this function face it here. Please note that we put in this function block talk play fun mem leak check checkpoint 1. This is macro. When this function block goes off, this macro reports memory leak. Start Microsoft compiler CLEHSCSED C++ 20 MDD leak detection.cpp FE M.exe. Please note that this switch is important. MD means multi-threaded dynamic link DLL. D means debug build. Copy this. I will paste it here. Hit enter. CLSM. So our message leak detection. This is leak detection.cpp at line 22. At line 22, checkpoint 1, 17 byte leaked. This is false positive. To prevent false positive, stream talk play fun flush. To prevent false positive leak report. Now we build again CLSM. No memory leak detection because we properly deleted the dynamic allocation. Now disable it. We build again CLSM. So at line 22, at line 22, checkpoint 1, checkpoint 1, 4 bytes leaked, 4 bytes allocated, but not deleted. So 4 bytes leaked. Please remember this switch, MDD. This feature works for Microsoft compiler only. Now, close this file, open overload.cpp, Ctrl-B, I will paste this link. I highly recommend you to read this book. If you want to download sample source code, you can double-click this link and download complete source code for C++ 17, the complete guide. Also, this link, using this link, you can download this PDF file. I do not recommend to overload operator new and delete. However, to better understand modern C++, we can try operator new and delete. We can try to overload. Once again, I do not recommend to overload operator new and delete by yourself. Include talk play fun output HBP. Include new for SED bad alloc exception. Talk play fun S stream stream constant auto and then talk play fun and there. We define our custom class, my class, semicolon, public. We create constructor, stream, constructor, called. We define destructor, my class, stream, destructor, called. Now we overload. Return type should be void pointer operator new size t count stream custom operator new called. And then we will simply use global operator new by passing count void operator delete void ptr stream custom operator delete called. And then we simply call operator delete ptr. Now void test custom class specific operator new delete. Int main, copy this, paste. Auto int ptr new int. We are calling global operator new for type int. Delete int ptr. Now here, auto class ptr new our class here delete class ptr stream. We will put new line character our message then and there and there. Now start your command prompt cls dir CLEHSCSDD C++ 20 overload.cpp fe m.exe hit enter CLSM. So in this case We call global new operator for built-in type constructor called. This function is called custom operator new custom operator new called. Then this global operator calls our constructor. So constructor called. Then our message here. Then destructor called. This delete operator, our message destructor called here. Then custom operator delete called. I will change the order. Then rebuild CLSM. Now custom operator new called, constructor called, our message destructor called, our custom operator delete called. Everything seems to work properly. We can't learn mathematics just by reading books. We have to solve the problems. We have to make our own problems. Then we can figure out more than your math book teaches you. In the same manner, we cannot learn computer programming just by reading books. We have to try the code in the book and we have to create our own program. Otherwise, we cannot learn computer programming.